Hey, what's good, everybody? So, if you could see, I did some aerial shots with the drone. All this used to, you know, be a work, a functioning community. You know, there were floods back in the days, and so, you know, everything got, you know, pretty much torn apart by the water. If you could hear, there's still a river that runs. I don't know if you could hear it. I didn't really get any drone footage of the river because all the trees are blocking it anyways in this section. But you know, yeah, it was, I mean, they had all the water they needed. Unfortunately, too much after, right? Because everything flooded. But you know, you could see the chimneys are still standing. You know, little fireplace. I'll edit in all the, you know, the drone footage. There were some other things I couldn't get into because there's too many trees in the way. But there's some other structures that are still standing. So yeah, I couldn't, there's just way too many trees for me to try to fly the drone in there. So, but yeah, there's all this, you know, there's remnants. You know, you saw the one that, or you'll see it. I don't know if I haven't edited in yet, but it looks like there was a swimming pool even, you know, which is funny because, you know, there's a river right here. And I'm sure back then it was a lot cleaner, you know, before. Or who knows, maybe there were so many people, you know, they felt like it wasn't clean, so they put in a swimming pool. So yeah, that's what this was. You know, I'll put a little more information. I'll look it up right now. But you know, this is something that, you know, all the way even to that bridge to nowhere, you see all these remnants of, you know, they were trying to build the road and it was supposed to connect way up north and everything. But you know, the flooding and everything, I think, is what put a halt to all that. So yeah. This is pretty crazy. Actually, I found that a lot of people, they don't even know about this. I found it just because I had to pee once. And, you know, I was on the road. You know, I walked a little bit just so, you know, they can't see me when I was peeing. Because, you know, a lot of people bring their kids up here to the mountains and everything. So, I stopped somewhere. I just started walking off. Recently, I showed a friend and they were like, oh, wow, I didn't know that. You know, like their whole life living around here and everything. So, you know, I happened to see it just because, you know, nature called. So that was it. But yeah, this is it's pretty crazy, you know. It's like ruins, you know, like where they find ruins. Oh, in Egypt, or I mean, this ain't nothing that old, but it's crazy how things just get buried underneath the trees and mountains. And unless you gotta go pee, then you know, you won't find it. All right, cool. Enjoy the footage. All right, peace. Okay, so this is the famous flood. It's called the Los Angeles flood of 1938. The Los Angeles flood of 1938 was one of the largest floods in the history of Los Angeles, Orange, and Riverside counties in Southern California. The flood was caused by two Pacific storms that swept across the Los Angeles basin in February through March of 1938 and generated almost 1 year's worth of precipitation in just a few days. Between 113 to 115 people were killed by the flooding. The Los Angeles, San Gabriel, and Santa Ana rivers burst their banks, inundating much of the coastal plain. The San Fernando and San Gabriel valleys and the Inland Empire flood control structures spared parts of Los Angeles County from destruction, while Orange and Riverside counties experienced more damage. The flood of 1938 is considered a 50-year flood. It caused $78 million of damage, which would be $1.43 billion in 2020 dollars, making it one of the costliest natural disasters in Los Angeles history. In response to the floods, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers and other agencies began to channelize local streams in concrete and built many new flood control dams and debris basins. The 1938 flood destroyed 5,601 homes and businesses and damaged a further 1,500 properties. The flooding was accompanied by massive debris, flows of mud, boulders, and downed trees, which surged out of the foothill canyons. Transport and communication were cut off for many days as roads and railroads were buried and power, gas, and communication lines were cut. Dozens of bridges were destroyed by the sheer erosive force of floodwaters or by the collision of floating buildings and other wreckage. Some communities were buried as much as 6 feet deep in sand and sediment, requiring a massive cleanup effort afterwards. It took from 2 days to a week to restore highway service to most impacted areas. The Pacific Electric Rail System serving Los Angeles, Orange, San Bernardino, and Riverside counties was out of service for 3 weeks. Although the 1938 flood caused the most damage of any flood in the history of Los Angeles, the rainfall and river peaks were not even close to the Great Flood of 1862, the largest known flood by total volume of water. However, during the 1862 flood, the region was much less populated than it was in 1938. Okay, so just to add to that, you know, it wasn't just the floods. Like, there were also fires and other things that had impacted these areas. So there's no telling what exactly destroyed these structures. You know, I tried to search for it, but as far as these, it didn't really say. You know, there were others that were directly impacted by the flood in other locations. I'll put some old pictures, some historic pictures that survived. I know it was, you know, a lot of miners during the gold rush. That's pretty much mostly what it was. And they started, you know, from squatting to people that were purchasing land. You know, they were coming, you know, European settlers, and then also some Mexican, I guess, investors that bought some mines or different things like that. So, you know, there was just a ton of that. So that's how they started building the community, pretty much all miners. And the funny thing is, they're still miners to this day. So you know, that's pretty interesting that people are still out there. I was told recently that there was this guy that someone met that had a gold nugget as a necklace to, like, show with pride how they had found gold in these canyons. So it's pretty funny, you know, that, I mean, you know, if you have the time, people are out there still mining, you know. So I thought that was pretty funny. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the video. You already know, comment, like, share, subscribe, you know, and thanks for watching. Peace.